Hello, ROS developers. Today we are going to start with a new project about how to do robot manipulation with ROS by using the Sawyer simulation. So you can see here, this is an example of a video that I found on YouTube about two Sawyer robots collaborating in order to create an espresso, so to produce espresso. So we are going to work with this Sawyer simulation that is already provided by Rethink Robotics. And in this first video, we are going to see how to get the simulation working. So let's go. First thing is we are going to use the ROS Development Studio. So for that, just go to the rds.theconstructsim.com and then create a free account, and then you are in. So once you are there, remember, don't go to the public area, but instead go to your My Projects area. In here, create a new project. Let's call it Sawyer Simulation, for instance. And so let's put a short description. So this is the simulation of Sawyer robot provided by Rethink Robotics. Okay, great. Created. Now let's open it. So we are going to open and then populate here the project with this simulation, and we'll use the simulation for later videos and later things that we are going to do in order to do manipulation. Okay, first thing, let's open a shell, and here in the shell, as you probably know, in the ROS Development Studio, we have several workspaces. Each one is aimed at different stuff. If you want to learn what each one is for, just have a look at our videos on how to develop for ROS using the ROS Development Studio. And today, because we are going to do the simulation, we need to use this workspace. So let's go there. Simulation workspace, and then source. This is an already created and running ROS workspace. Okay, so we have everything set up there. Now, let's go to the simulation that provides Rethink Robotics. So if you go to this address, I will put it beneath this video. So I will put this link so you can copy and paste for yourself. Here is the Git. And here's some instructions about how to install it in your own computer. So in case that you would like to follow this procedure for your own computer, you can also do it, of course. You will need to have Ubuntu, Kinetic, and Gazebo 7 installed. In our case here, it's ready. Everything is configured. So we only need to go to the simulation installation, of course. We don't have to skip this step because we already have the workspace. So we go for the clone of the Git. So copy paste here and let's clone it. Done it. Next step is, okay, so we go to the same workspace and then initialize the workspace. So let's do it. And then merge with the ROS install. Those are basic instructions. So that's it. And now let's update the workspace. This is going to install anything that is required, extra required for the simulation. Remember, all those files are already provided by Rethink Robotics. So we are basically doing nothing here. It's just downloading. And then the only thing that remains is to build. So we had to go, well, this source is not required because our workspace already has done it. So let's do the cat key make. For this, we need to get down one directory and then do the cat key make. So this is going to compile the simulation and prepare it and have it ready. So this is going to take a while. So in the meantime, that it's compiling everything. Remember that here we have all the dependencies already installed in the ROS Development Studio. So it's going to work. It may happen that in your case, maybe at your home, if you are doing this in your own local computer, you will have some requirements for dependencies and it will not compile. So you will have to solve this by yourself. If you want to avoid that trouble, please come here to the Rust Development Studio and do it there online. It's very easy. You can use any type of machine. You can keep working from anywhere. So I don't see the problem of working here. This is very convenient. And another thing that I would like to tell you is that we are going to learn how to do Rust manipulation for this robot. And in case that you are interested in learning more, let me recommend you the Robot Ignite Academy. That is the academy where you can learn online about Rust, any subject of Rust. And the tutorials, they include already the simulation, like in the Rust Development Studio, like here, as you are going to see in a minute. So you don't need to install anything on your computers, and you will be practicing at the same time with the simulation that you are learning following the tutorials. So, for example, in this case, this Rust manipulation in 5 days course is going to be very helpful in order to understand what we are going to do there with Rust, with the Sawyer simulation. So you can get some details here about what is the course about and the different robots that you are using for learning. So give it a try. I will put the link of this academy on at the bottom. And let's see if this is already compiled. All right, very good. So it's already compiled. So now let's go and launch the simulation. For this, you don't need to do a Rust launch or else, because everything is already prepared to make it easier. To launch your own simulation that is installed here in this CADKIN workspace, just go to the simulations menu, select the launch file. This is for launching a simulation in your workspace. You have to get this option. In case that you would like to launch any other robot simulation that we already provide off the shelf, just click on them and they will appear for you, okay? So now let's launch Sawyer, sorry, the one that we would like to use. So select launch file here. Let's go and select the one that does the pick and place demo. So select this one and launch. A new window will appear here that will show us the gazebo simulation of Sawyer. So let's make it bigger. We can see better. So here is the log of the launching of the simulation, indicating how everything is running, and here it's starting to appear the simulation. Let me hide the log and let's go a little bit backwards. So here we have the Sawyer simulation performing this pick and place demo. Okay, great. So we have it running now. Then perfect. So that was the point for this video today here. And we are going to finish here. And in case that you are interested on checking anything, you can also go to the code by opening here the IDE and check all the code of the simulation that is installed here in the simulation workspace. Here you have all the code that we have downloaded. Also, you can check any other launch file that are available in order to see how interesting could it be. The simulation, that's up to you. Check it out and I'll wait for you for the next video where we are going to start configuring Baxter with MoveIt in order to allow the robot to start creating trajectories. So thank you very much for coming to this project and following this video. In case that you like it, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and pressing the bell also, because we publish a new video about Rust every day. So by subscribing and pressing the bell, you will be notified when we publish this new video. So thank you very much and see you on the next video. Cheers, bye.